Good morning, teachers. This is a presentation on Staphylococcus aureus. This presentation has been prepared by Prince, David, Arushi, Kratik, and Rituraj. Let's have an overview of Staphylococcus. Staphylococcus are gram-positive spherical bacteria that occurs in microscopic cluster resembling grapes. Bacteriological culture of the nose and skin of normal humans invariably yields Staphylococcus. In 1884, Rosenbach described the two pigmented color type of staphylococci and proposed the appropriate nomenclature. Now let's take a look at the features of Staphylococcus. Staphylococcus are gram-positive round cocci, forms grape-like structure. It is non-motile. It is mesophilic in nature, having optimum temperature about 37 degrees Celsius. It has 40 species. It produces yellow or orange pigment, and its habitat includes skin and mucous membrane of human and small components of soil microbial flora. Now Arushi will help us explain and know about Staphylococcus aureus.
Staphylococcus aureus is a yellow pigment colony which was discovered in Scotland by Sir Alexander Oxon in 1880. Staphylococcus aureus belongs to the domain of bacteria, phylum Firmicutes, class Bacilli, order Bacillus, family Staphylococcus, genus Staphylococcus. Now discuss what the Staphylococcus aureus means. Staph is a reference to the clusters of grapes that the organism forms. Coccus part refers to the round shape of the bacteria. Aureus is from its golden color. Now discuss the features of Staphylococcus aureus. Staphylococcus aureus is a gram-positive cocci-shaped bacteria having size of about 0.7 to 0.9 micrometer in diameter. They are facultative anaerobe, that is, they can survive at both aerobic as well as anaerobic condition. They are non-motile and does not form spores. They are unencapsulated or have a limited capsule. They are catalase positive, oxidase negative, and coagulase positive. They can ferment lactic acid from glucose and also can ferment mannitol. Under ideal conditions, Staphylococcus aureus can grow within temperature range of 7 to 48.5 degrees Celsius, whereas optimum temperature range is 30 to 37 degrees Celsius. They can survive well at low temperature. Ability of Staphylococcus aureus to tolerate heat depends on the food type in which the organism is being heated, and they can be well destroyed by the pasteurization. And the requirement of pH for Staphylococcus aureus to grow is 4.2 to 9.3, whereas the optimum pH requirement is 6 to 7. And the habitat for Staphylococcus aureus is part of normal skin flora and nasal passages.
Is aureus pathogenicity among different toxins? Endotoxin is responsible for major food poisoning outbreaks. And also, as aureus is capable of growing and producing endotoxin in raw milk, and not all the strains of microorganism are capable of producing endotoxin. The toxin production is faster in milk with low count. And as aureus virulence gene expression is regulated, is critical in defining the pathogenesis of Staphylococcus diseases. And different metabolic end products by Staphylococci toxins are hemolysin, leukocidin, necrotizing factor, coagulase, lethal factor, and endotoxin. And hemolysis are toxins that are lyse red blood cells, and their action is usually receptor mediated. There are many classes of hemolysins, including alpha, beta, and gamma hemolysins. Alpha hemolysin has been classified as a phenol soluble modulin (PSM) that does not require a receptor for its hemolytic activity. And alpha hemolysin is the most well studied member of staphylococcal hemolysins. Leukotoxins lyse white blood cells and most likely require receptors for their mode of action, although the receptor remained mostly uncharacterized until recently. And also, endotoxin cause Enterotoxin cause vomiting and diarrhea, and the toxin are one of the most common cause of foodborne diseases. The toxins are secreted by enterotoxigenic strain in food. They are heat stable, not degraded by cooking process, and there are more than 20 identified ACCs to date. They are differently based on antigenic heterogeneity.
Significance of Staphylococcus aureus. Staphylococcus aureus affects the quality and safety of dairy products, for example, ham and cheese sandwich, raw and pasteurized milk, cream cheese and yogurt. And role in health of Staphylococcus aureus. The bacterium occurs widely in low numbers on the skin and mucous membrane of warm blood animal. Normally, the bacterium is transient and not a part of resident flora on skin. If the normal balance of the skin flora is disturbed, frequent washing, antibiotic treatment, Staphylococcus aureus may become established as a part of the resident flora. It can cause a wide range of disease, including skin infections in internal organs, and intoxications such as toxic shock syndrome and food poisoning.
Mastitis. It is one of the most common disease in the animals, mainly cow and buffalo, in which there is a large compositional change in the milk and also the stability of the milk. Mastitis. It is mainly caused by the many of the bacteria species, but mainly the Staphylococcus aureus is mainly responsible for this disease in the animals. These bacteria enter the udder by the tea duct, and it is able to colonize itself in a large amount. Staphylococcus aureus is one of the most frequent case in the foodborne disease. It also causes the food intoxication, as it is rarely mentioned among the most important food pathogens, probably because of the limited severity of the illness. Methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, MRSA. It is one of the different strain of the Staphylococcus aureus. Now, what makes MRSA different from the other Staphylococcus species? Because it cannot be killed by any of the antibiotics. Mainly, it is also known as the superbug in the media, and it causes the skin infections also. Most strains of the Staphylococcus aureus are penicillin resistant. Resistance is mainly due to the unusual penicillin binding protein. The infection which is causing by the MRSA is likely to be require longer hospitalization, with incumbent increased cost than infection with a methicillin susceptible strain. A Staphylococcus infection occurs when Staphylococcus aureus bacteria enters in the body, as you see in this PPT. Like in the first image, it is shown the bacteria enters in the body, and in the second image there is a symptom which causes the redness and the pain. Now, the prevention and control. There are many methods to prevent and control the growth of the Staphylococcus aureus to save our milk and the milk products from it, or also yourself from this, because it is also cause the skin infection in our body. Staphylococcus aureus, as you all know, it produces the enterotoxin. The adequate heating destroys the Staphylococcus but not the enterotoxin. So, heating within few hours of the production would also inhibit the multiplication of the Staphylococcus and no toxin produced. Adequate cooling immediately after producing milk also inhibits multiplication of Staphylococcus aureus. The post-pasteurization contamination should be avoided. Infected handlers should not be allowed to handle the milk, because their hands and the skin contains the Staphylococcus aureus, and due to which it enters into the milk and the milk products. Animals having mastitis should be isolated from the herd, because if they are in the herd, they also transmits the disease from one animal to another animal and also infects the milk production.
Diagnosis. For diagnosis and detection of Staph aureus, we keep in mind the following features: its morphology, its pigment color, its hemolytic nature, facultative nature, catalase nature, oxidase and coagulase nature. Gram staining. While doing gram staining, we exploit the morphology of Staph aureus. We know that Staphylococcus aureus is gram positive in nature. It is cocci in cluster. Therefore, it helps in detection of Staph aureus. But this test is not sufficient to help us detect the Staph aureus. Therefore, we resolve to culture. In culture, blood agar. We incubate it for 18 to 24 hours. Yellow or golden yellow colonies with or without beta hemolysis are seen. And when it is seen, we can infer that Staph aureus is present. Here, the hemolytic nature of Staph aureus is being exploited. Mannitol salt agar. It is a selective media commonly used for the isolation of Staph aureus. We inoculate and incubate for 24 to 48 hours at about 35 degrees Celsius. Yellow colonies of Staph aureus in mannitol salt agar shows us the presence of Staph aureus in the culture. Baird-Parker test. It is a selective medium for the isolation and presumptive identification of coagulase-positive staphylococci. It has a selective agent called lithium chloride and potassium telluride, which produces dark gray to black colonies due to telluride reduction. Achiol is used as a substrate to detect lecithinase production and lipase activity. Staphylococci that produce lecithinase break down the egg yolk and cause clear zone around respective colonies. An opaque zone of precipitation may form due to lipase activity. Here, the coagulase positive nature of Staphylococcus has been exploited. The third principle is known as biochemical test. Here, the catalase positive nature of Staphylococcus is being used to detect the presence of Staph aureus. We add 3% hydrogen peroxide to colony on an agar plate. If oxygen and bubble are formed, we infer that it is catalase positive, therefore Staph aureus is present. But if there is no presence of oxygen and bubble, we infer that Staph aureus is absent. Coagulase test. 0.5 ml of human plasma with 0.1 ml of an overnight broth culture of Staph aureus. We incubate it in water bath for 3 to 6 hours at about 37 degrees Celsius. If blood clot and the tube does not flow when inverted, we infer that it is coagulase positive, therefore Staph aureus is present. But if there is no coagulation and the tube flows when inverted, it is coagulase negative and Staph aureus is absent. So these were some of the ways by which it helps to detect and isolate Staph aureus. So today we talked about the morphology of Staph aureus, how its shape and its features helps to distinguish it from different species of Staphylococcus, and also how it helps in detection and how it helps in isolation. We talked about its significance. We talked about how it impacts in dairy industry. We talked about how it impacts our health, and also it impacts many diseases that are causing because of Staphylococcus aureus. Hence, as earlier mentioned, Staphylococcus aureus is one of the most important species of Staphylococcus, and its study helps in prevention and control of Staph aureus. So this was our short presentation on Staphylococcus aureus. Thank you and have a nice day.